Thank you.
She's passionate about the mission. And you can't be the leader of such an organization without being passionate about its mission. Janet, she was an excellent choice because of who she is, what she stands for, and the way she carries herself.
Raul, thank you again for all your sacrifice and for all your dedication.
Janet brings a very interesting perspective to the National Dialogue on Latinos. Having come from the Midwest, where one doesn't think of it being one of the population centers of the Latino population. And yet her family experience shows that perseverance can really pay off. She's from a family that has had exceptional success. And then she's demonstrated that she can use those talents to help others as well.
She's always seen the power that can come by building bridges. And she works with Republican members of Congress as easily as she works with Democratic members of Congress. And she works with people who don't agree with her just as easily as people who do agree with her. Because if we're just speaking to the choir all the time, that congregation doesn't grow.
She has been tough, both on her foes and on her friends, equally tough. And that is a very, very difficult thing to do. But Janet has a very, very clear sense of her role and her obligation to the community. And you have a very special visionary leader in Janet.
Everybody was thinking that President Barack Obama has been deporting way too many immigrants in this country, more than 2 million. And a lot of people were afraid to say that. But then Janet came and she said that President Barack Obama was deporter in chief. Well, that was tough, but somebody needed to say that. And she had the strength and the energy and the credibility to say that.
Janet Merguia used her formidable stature and the organization's power to say something that I think we'll look back on as the turning point in our generation's immigration debate.
For NCLR, she's become not just a tremendous voice, but she's become a national voice for Latinos and for Americans who believe in that American dream.
When the president announced the expansion of DACA and DAPA, it was a press conference that was convened and spearheaded by Janet that had not just Latino leadership, but really a representation of Americans saying that this is an American issue, not a Latino issue.
The National Council of La Raza has also been a great partner of not only the National Urban League, but many of the historic civil rights organizations working on issues like civic engagement, housing, technology, and education. We have worked with them. We have walked hand in hand with them on so many important issues.
Is that talent that she has of bringing people together so that we're focusing on the objectives that we all share that have help to make NCLR as effective as it is today.
Let me just suggest to everybody that what NCLR and Janet Merguia in particular are building is gonna dominate American politics for the very foreseeable future.
I have seen her really reach out in a very deep and meaningful way to affiliates. And she is helping build capacity within the affiliate network. She's trying to listen to what the issues are at the affiliate level.
And because Janet has invested in the local affiliates and in that relationship, it's made NCLR incredibly important in Washington.
When working with Janet, she really has this expectation of everyone around her to do their very best.
She has served as a mentor. She has always had her door open, has made herself available, has given us the time to talk to us, to provide insight and advice and mentorship.
She was invited to the bill signing for Dodd-Frank financial reform, and she invited me to go along with her. And she really was like, this is your day. She took my camera, and she started taking pictures of me with all the congressional members. But she's like, this is the issue that you've been passionate about for the last 2 years. This is your day. And it was an awesome day.
A bright future awaits us if we dare to claim it, a future that will lift up our community and strengthen our country. Let's not leave this work unfinished.
To see a woman, especially in the Latino community, head up what is one of the premier organizations for us on a national and international basis was incredibly thrilling. And of course, she had the chops to do it.
Well, Janet is as good as it gets. She's smart, she's tough, she's informed, and the Latino community really is fortunate to have the quality of leadership that Janet represents.